the greatest of this all, it's love. Really love you, faithful and love.
Shake 'em up! Wait a minute! This is Sending Some Love, What's Up with the Apostle. Now I want to talk you, share with you what I experienced, what I call the fall. When the Flight 39 Alaska began its taxi down the runway ever so slowly, then it hit a final turn. As it went from 5 to 80 in seconds, the jet engines accelerated and my heart exploded with excitement and joy. It's like, oh boy, we're really going. Oh, it's on. I felt something rip away from me like a cover of some sort as I saw it lift the higher altitude the plane climbed. I was brought to tears as I was listening to my worship music, Donna McClurkin. Because you know when you go on the plane, it's got to go on airplane mode. But thank God a month before that, Pandora had this offer, $5 for the month. And because when you lose signal, it makes a special station, offline station. Thank you, Jesus. It was offline and it was off the hook. The worship music I was listening to was Donna McClurkin. Great is thy mercies towards me. You're always providing for me. I was reminded of how my mind had shut down in 2008 after I was informed of charges that I was supposed to have molested my son. What kept my mind intact was singing this song over and over as I walked from the probation office, and I'm trying to figure out why I gotta go to the probation office, and this was due to domestic violence, verbal abuse. And so I'm singing that song, great is thy mercies towards me. You're always providing for me. Great is thy mercies I see day after day. Forever faithful towards me. You're always providing for me. Great is thy mercies I see day after day. Now I'm singing this song. I done left the probation officer. That's on St. Mark's up in Staten Island. I'm walking down the hill past the Supreme Court, singing the song, walking up to the St. George Ferry, tears coming down my eyes. I'm getting on the ferry boat, still singing that song, same way, tears rolling down, people moving out of my way. Even a 30-minute ride across Staten Island, the bay, into New York City, St. George, I'm still singing that song. Because that was the only way I could keep my mind from being shut down permanently. When I get off the ferry boat, as I proceed to get ready to go down the subway, I heard a demon say, if you go down there, you're going to die. Just as quick as he said that, the Holy Spirit said, look up there, take that ride all the way up to Harlem. It took me 3 months before I could get down in the subway because the Holy Spirit had to tell me to buy myself an iPod shuffle, put my worship music on it, because what I was dealing with during this fight was a rejection demon on every post. So when I had to go here and there and this and that, trying to get my housing, trying to get this, and all these things I had to meet, plus running the ministry now. I was still doing ministry. It didn't matter. I would put the iPod shuffle on and go on. And 3 months later, I was able to get down there. So I thank God for that because it allowed me to know that it didn't matter what was going on. He said, if you be about my business, I'm going to be about yours. And God truly was about mine. And so once I got back, I thank God that time in homelessness was now a new total trusting in God. So that experience I had then, and to hear that song right then as I'm accelerating into higher altitudes, looking out on the cloud, beautiful clouds, excuse me, beautiful cloud formation, and it's a ray of sun trying to come through. I got the photo, I'm going to put it in with this video. the tears began rolling down my eyes on the plane. Because I remember what God had done for me back then in that dire situation. And here I was, a youthful 65, hallelujah, taking my Abraham journey, going somewhere where I didn't know anybody but the Lord, doing what God said do and trusting God. And I knew as that song came on that I was good. I was good. So I knew without a doubt that God would do what he said he would do, just as he did it back then when I was dealing with domestic violence and verbal abuse when I became homeless. The trauma and the torment that I endured back then. I looked out the window and saw the many clouds, formation of peace.
Have you eaten from the everlasting bread of life? Have you drunk of the living water? Or seeking in this life to prosper? But are you satisfied with the life?